Good day, everyone. Welcome to Bozo TV. I'm Akambi RO, Civic Education Teacher. This morning, we are looking at a topic, National Consciousness, Symbols and Identity. When we talk about national consciousness is the state of being able to use your sense and mental power to understand what is happening in a particular country or a nation. Also, you can say that national consciousness is the feeling one has as a member of a particular nation. You are not just a citizen, but it is expected of you as a citizen of Nigeria to have the feeling and being aware of the happenings in your nation. What is a nation? A nation is a community of people who are united under a single government and share many things in common. What are those things that we share in common as a nation? We have a common territory, we have a common constitution, armed forces, economic life, and political system. We share all this together as a nation. Now, this will lead me to patriotism. Patriotism is the ability and willingness of the citizen to promote and uphold the basic characteristics and existence of a country. It means the great love for one's country. We always recite it in our pledge every day, that we pledge to Nigeria, our country, to be faithful, loyal, and honest, to serve Nigeria with all our strength. So that strength, that ability is the great love that we have for our country. Now, let's look at national identity. National identity refers to the characteristics by which a nation can be recognized. Or we can say that it's the ability and willingness of the citizen to realize, promote, and uphold the basic characteristics and existence of a country. Now, we have different national symbols. And under these national symbols, we have the Nigerian National Coat of Arms, we have the national flag, we have the national anthem, the national pledge, national currency, national passport, and the constitution. Before we look at all these national symbols one after the other, let's look at what is the meaning of national symbols. National symbols are expression of signs and values which the nation holds as important for the citizens. They are the signs that distinguish one country from other countries. Out of all these national symbols which I've mentioned, the coat of arms, the flag, the national anthem, the national pledge, the constitution, the unity lamp, and so on. Now let me talk on the coat of arms. When we talk about the coat of arms is also called armorial bearing. What do I call it? I called it armorial bearing. The coat of arms is a set of pictures painted on a sheet and used as the special sign of a country. The Nigerian coat of arms stands for the country authority, strength, unity, and wealth. It has a motto of unity and faith, peace, and progress. Now, if you look at the coat of arms, there's a black sheet in which the two horses and the eagle rest on. The black sheet in the coat of arms stand for the fertile land of the country, which is agriculture. Why there's something that look like letter Y, we call it slavery bands, which represents the river Niger and river Benue. That is the two important rivers in Nigeria and their confluence. Their confluence is their meeting point. Where the two rivers meet, we call it confluence stand. And the confluence stand is located at a place called Kogi, Lokoja State. The two horses on the coat of arms stand for integrity and dignity of the country, while the big bird, the eagle, depicts the strength and pride of the nation. If you look at it critically, you see a flowering plant at the bottom of the sheet. That flowering plant at the bottom of the sheet is a species of cactus plants, and this represents the tenacity and resilience of the people of Nigeria, which is the beauty of the people of Nigeria. Now, having understand what the coat of arms stand for, Remember, I said another name for it is armorial bearing, and it has the motto of unity and faith, peace and progress. Now let's look at the national flag. The national flag is a piece of cloth used in identifying a country, and it is expressing its beliefs, its values, and the people of the nation. This national flag came into existence when Nigeria became independent. Nigeria got our independence on 1st of October 1960. And this national flag was designed by a man called Michael Taiwo Akinkunmi in 1959. But this national flag came to use in 1960, as at the time Nigeria got our independence. That was the time the national flag was unfolded for the first time. This national flag is divided into three equal vertical parts of green, white, and green. The green color stands for agriculture, while the white color stands for peace and unity. I said the national flag is divided into three, but it has two colors, the color green and the white. The green stands for agriculture, the white stands for peace and unity. And don't forget, I said it was designed in 1959 by a man called Taiwo Akinkunmi. Now let's look at the national currency. The national currency is an official medium of exchange used by citizens in that particular nation. The naira and kobo is the official medium of exchange in Nigeria. This currency represents the legal tender, that is the means of payment. We exchange it from one hand to the other. That is, the money is officially used and accepted in Nigeria. We use naira only in Nigeria, not in other countries of the world. The naira note in all its denomination is also identified with Nigeria all over the world. You know, we have different denominations, starting from 5 naira, 10 naira, 20 naira, 50 naira, 100 naira, 200, 500, and 1000 naira. If I should ask, each denomination has a picture of an individual appears on it. Like 100 naira has the picture of Obafemi Awolowo, 20 naira has the picture of Muritala, and so on. I believe you enjoyed today's class. Try to view our page. See you next class. Goodbye.